self-proclaimed voodoo priest charged with disgusting animal abuse ritual, what do you think his punishment should be? Dogs are truly man's best friend, and while they certainly act up from time to time, they're fiercely loyal creatures. That's why it's often so disgusting to see someone abuse such a kind animal, but in this case, what one Florida resident did to his pit bull is so far worse than anything we've ever seen, that words can't even describe it. Most Americans have had a dog at some point in their lives, whether it be a golden retriever, a Labrador, or a beagle, we can all relate to the joy that having a loving best buddy gives us. While many of us may have gotten mad at our dogs for pooping in the house, none of us could ever imagine doing what Brendan Evans just did to his dog. The 31-year-old Florida resident, who is a self-proclaimed voodoo priest, faces up to 5 years in prison and a $10,000 fine if he's convicted. While many people have claimed that this punishment is far too harsh for a case of animal abuse, just wait until you learn what he did to his pet pit bull, Ollie. Police found him stuffed inside of a blue suitcase, tucked back in an alleyway, after hearing the dog's cries for help. Upon opening the suitcase, the police officers were shocked to find a weak, but still living pit bull that had been stabbed over 50 times. He was immediately rushed to the animal hospital, and a crowdfunding page was set up. Fox News reports. A Florida man who claimed to be a voodoo priest was charged Wednesday with aggravated animal cruelty in the fatal beating and mutilation of a pit bull whose condition caused a national outcry. Brendan Evans, 31, faces up to 5 years in prison and a $10,000 fine if convicted. The pit bull, named Ollie, was found stuffed inside a blue suitcase in an alley October 10 after officers followed the sound of his cries. He had been stabbed more than 50 times. Ollie died at an animal hospital 2 days after he was found. His story led to adoption offers from around the country, and a GoFundMe page set up for him raised about $40,000 before his death. Hollywood detectives and officers have seen and investigated animal cruelty cases before, but none as horrific as what we've seen in the case of Ollie, said police spokeswoman Miranda Grossman. Unfortunately, this poor dog didn't make it out alive after being subject to incredibly inhumane torture. We will not tolerate any form of animal cruelty or violence in our city, Hollywood Acting Police Chief Chris O'Brien said in a statement. Each reported case of animal cruelty, be it physical abuse or neglect, is disturbing, and this case is particularly heartbreaking. We were all pulling for Ollie to survive, but unfortunately he didn't make it. Thankfully, O'Brien added that there will be justice for this complete scumbag who abused such an innocent animal. Due to our investigation, he says, we are now able to provide justice for Ollie. Many believe that he should get more than 5 years in prison, but presumably it's on the judge to decide. According to a police report, officers who searched Evans' apartment November 14 discovered several mutilated rats in the freezer, along with two cat paws, knives covered with dried blood and animal fur. Officers also discovered an 8-pointed star as well as a candlelit shrine that included pieces of a flyer about Ollie's death. They also found notes, one of which read, "Make the entire pit bull investigation go away. Return all curses placed on Brendan to their sender. Give Brendan peace of mind." As officers searched his apartment, the Sun Sentinel newspaper reported, Evans posted a message on Facebook claiming to be a voodoo priest. DNA taken from the suitcase where Ollie was found was a match for Evans, and WSVN reported officers found one of the pit bull's teeth in the suspect's wallet. The Sun Sentinel reported that Evans was arrested by Broward County Sheriff's deputies in 2012 on domestic battery charges and is currently on probation for a 2015 bank robbery in Hernando County. WSVN reported that Evans' fingerprints also link him to a residential burglary in Hollywood. The paper also reported that a Fort Lauderdale police officer spotted Evans attempting to kick a duck and her ducklings. When questioned, Evans said he wanted to kill the ducks because he practices voodoo. Police said Evans also purchased two kittens this past June from a person in Delray Beach who called police when Evans called back a few days later requesting to buy more kittens. Neighbors of Evans expressed relief at his capture, with one telling WSVN, "He could have graduated and moved up, you know, So I'm just glad that they got him. In a world where far too many animal abusers get away with their disgusting acts of torture, many are relieved to find that Evans will be charged. What do you think his punishment should be, however? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section below. We want to hear your voice.